net zero has to be accompanied by zero hunger and zero poverty. Climate and development, not as opposite parts of the house and contradictory in nature, but actually as two sides of the same coin.
Africa contributes 3.8% of GHG emissions globally, but the impact of climate change is not 3.8% on Africa. It's actually quite severe. But at the same time, we see only about 7% of global investments in renewable energy projects and infrastructure in Africa. Only 7%. So this has to change.
We don't want to lose our ecosystems, nor we don't even want to lose our biodiversities because of one little thing, and that is ignorance. That's why at this COP, since it's happening here in Africa, we're demanding for loss and damage finance.
When we are making decisions, when we are having these discussions, I think the constituent, the individual, the grassroots citizen of the world should be on top of the agenda and should be prioritized.
We are now cutting down all the trees so that we are able to process our farm produce. We want to get the innovations to help us turn our institutions to using green energy against the current dependence on good fuel.
We can collaborate on research and development. We don't need to operate in silos to gather the same data.
With data, we are able to get direct insights on what is damaging the climate precisely, and then we're able to provide the solutions and make better decisions.
We have the reservoir of this carbon credit that we can use. We need to have a price for carbon that will enable Africa to have resources to protect the most vulnerable in this climate change.
We're also looking at solar energy, wind energy, geothermal energy, and sustainable transport.
The billions and the trillions will only come to Africa if you create scale. Only 2 years ago, we had a few hundred megawatts. We've acquired the largest wind platform in Africa, called Lekela, and now we are the largest player in Africa together with our partners. We have 1.4 gigawatts of renewable energy in Africa. No one has that. Our target is to get to 3 gigawatts. And once you get to that size, you appear on the radar screen of the large investors that are willing to invest billions of dollars into renewable projects.
What's made us successful in the Lekela deal and everything else we do is that we're very quick to adapt to problems that arise. And we work to mitigate these problems in a logical and sound manner. So I think that's the mindset that you need to be able to do successful projects in general and specifically in Africa.
The message now is quite understood. The issue is to find proactive government with proactive institutions and start designing facilities for project preparation.
We're setting the scene, we're showing, we're demonstrating that these projects are bankable, they're profitable, and we're looking to attract third-party capital as well.